which has no end. Graciously receive our prayers. Deliver and preserve us. To you alone, O Father, be all glory, honor, and worship, with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ, in the night when he was betrayed, took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also he took the cup after supper. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
Now may this, the true body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen and preserve you in body and soul to life everlasting. Amen. We stand and sing together the post-communion canticle, Thank the Lord, on page 164. We give thanks to you, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us through this salutary gift. We implore you that of your mercy you would strengthen us through the same in faith toward you and in fervent love toward one another. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen.
You may be seated for a few announcements. Once again, we welcome Pastor Ellingworth here to bring us God's Word today. We thank you again for coming, and we look forward to continue being in God's Word so that we might go out and share the good news with others. We have some opportunities to study God's Word today following the service. Kids will be up here for opening before heading to your classrooms. Adults will be down in the library around 10:30. We will have a little bit of a shorter Bible study today. We'll have to be done a little before 11 for our budget voters meeting today. That'll be down in the basement starting at 11 o'clock. So if you are a voting member or want to become a voting member, you can join us downstairs. There's some information on the insert, too, about some of the work that specifically the quilters have been doing. They've decided not to come together anymore to quilt officially, and so we remember them, as well as all of the rest of the circles over the years, and all that LWML has done, as well as the other components of ladies' societies. We thank God for the gifts that he has given to us through them. Also, there's an explanation about the cover art from Full of Eyes, if you'd like to look at that. It's really a nice explanation. Looking ahead on the calendar, too, we have adult choir again next week in the morning, 8:15, before the service. We will be singing next week, so if you'd like to join us for that, we sure appreciate it. Next Sunday is the fourth Sunday, the last Sunday of the month, so we'll be doing our prayer and potluck. That'll start following Bible study at 11 o'clock. We've been learning about the fruits of the Spirit this year, so please join us for that. In a couple Sundays, the first Sunday in November, we have that dreaded, evil, satanic daylight saving time, although at the very least, we get an extra hour this time. So please make note of that on November 2nd, or earlier if you'd like to confuse yourself for longer. There's some information, too, about a soup luncheon for LWML at Trinity in Osage there on the bottom of the announcements page. This coming week, on Wednesday, the LYF Rotating Bible Study is going to be in Riceville at 6. Rides are available if you'd like to come to that. That's been a great thing for our circuit. All right, I think that's all I have for today. Does anybody have any other announcements? All right, we'll close today by singing hymn number 855. And please note again, verse 2, that second verse we'll be using verse 11 for Mary Magdalene. So we'll sing verse 1, verse 11, and then verses 3 and 4. Thank you.